This Saturday, February 1st, is National Freedom Day. The day honors the signing of the resolution that later became the 13th Amendment to the Constitution abolishing slavery. Here with me now to talk more about civil rights is Father Daniel Kingsley of St. Martin de Porres Parish in Brooklyn. Welcome, Father.
Welcome. Thank you for having me. I'm happy to be here this evening.
Okay, so I would venture to say that a lot of people don't even know what National Freedom Day is. Mm-hmm. Why is it so important for everyone to honor and celebrate it?
I think it pivots to what the founding fathers said about making this a more perfect union. We have to recall at the beginning of the country's history, African Americans were considered 3/5 of a person. And it's not until the bloody conflict of the Civil War that we realize that slavery cannot exist in a country that claims itself to be a democracy, honoring the rights and freedoms of all. And that finally, with the abolition of slavery, we could recognize human beings, but still more work to be done as we see in the unfolding of the country's history, Reconstruction, segregation, Jim Crow, and 1960s civil rights movement, but even still more work to be done at the present hour.
And as you mentioned, for African Americans, this is especially important. According to the NAACP, African Americans are imprisoned at more than 5 times the rate of whites. I know this is a very complicated question, but what do you think could possibly be done to change that statistic?
I think we as a country have to take seriously criminal justice reform. We say that everyone has a right to legal representation if they can afford it. But as we know, unfortunately, in many jurisdictions, public defenders are often overworked. It was revealed in one study that public defenders only have maybe 5 minutes for the many, many clients they see. And that, mind you, if you're being prosecuted for a crime that may risk you losing life or limb, you want your lawyer to be prepared to have all the facts. But if you don't have access to quality representation, you're doomed to go to prison. But I think that's one of many facets of criminal justice reform that need to be tackled if we wish to reverse this trend of the incarceration of too many black and brown people. Because again, how does 13% of the population represent almost 80 or 90% of the prison population?
Right. And you're a lifelong New Yorker, like myself, and as progressive as our city is, there are still a lot of tensions. Some would say that they feel like African Americans are still being profiled by police. Mm-hmm. Do you believe that's still the case? Do you still think we have a lot more to go?
I think our city's recent history in the last 20, 30 years reveals that. I think Bill de Blasio said it best, the tale of two New Yorks. I grew up in a house where it was discussed with heated passion, Amna Louima, Amadou Diallo, and Eric Gardner. And I think when you speak to many black and brown New Yorkers, they'll tell you that this is a trend of whenever they encounter law enforcement, there's a disregard for their civil rights. When you speak to white New Yorkers, there's a feeling that, well, if you'd only obey the law, but since when, for example, in the case of Eric Gardner, does selling a loose cigarette risk one not only losing their life, but the violation of their constitutional rights?
It's such a complicated issue. Thank you so much, Father Daniel Kingsley of St. Martin de Porres Parish in Brooklyn. Thank you for being here with us.
Thank you for having me.
If you're watching Currents News on YouTube, be sure to hit the subscribe button and then click on the bell to get instant updates about all of our newest content, because we are putting your faith in the news.